just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He's brought down in the open field. About the 46. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Hey, kill, kill, kill. Green flag. Motion,
motion. Go. From their own 46-yard line, second down. They hand it off. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. He heaves it deep. Very good tackle in space.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
And he's taken down around the 3-yard line. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. Play and he'll lose yards. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
Tackle made at the 2-yard line. This is the 9th play of this drive. For extra yardage. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. And the goal line defense digging in here. Touchdown, Texas! Tacks on the extra point.
So a 10-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
From his own goal line, makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Tulane's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps it go.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup, and if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
Man left, man left. Go down, go down.
10. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
He's taken down around the 20-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Is up a score. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Man, it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown.
Saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he adds the extra point. So a four-play, 41-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 14-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Second down and 11. Ball on their own 24. He's pushed out of bounds around the 28-yard line. Got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 38. The screen play worked that time for a decent pickup.
Yep, you're right. Excellent call to go to the screen to maybe slow down this defensive pass rush a little bit.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38. They'll get him for a loss.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
They come out in a five-wide set. Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down right around the 44-yard line. And so it's another third down upcoming here. And they make the stop right around midfield.
Chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game.
And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33. We're through one quarter. The Longhorns lead it by 2 touchdowns. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. He's going to be sacked for a loss.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. The sub package in there defensively. And this 5 wide receiver set. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Tackle at about the 3-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Tenth play of the drive.
Q26, Q26. Check.
He's tackled at the 2.
That brings him second and goal.
It's second and goal. 2 yards to the end zone. Defense stacked in tight here. Touchdown, Green Wave. He makes the PAT. Tulane to kick. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Texas up 7 points. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Catches it. He's immediately tackled behind the line. That's a 2-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
We've got 3rd and 12. Ball on their own 20. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He throws it. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
He's tackled at the 46. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Mike three.
Throws, and it's knocked away.
You know, the safety's responsibility, Brad, is to always make sure nothing is going to get behind it. You cannot ever get beat deep.
but also he has a responsibility to step up and make a play on the football in front of him. It's just another example of a defensive back, in this case a safety, just having really good instincts to be able to come up and know when to come up to knock that ball away.
From the 31-yard line, first down. And down he goes at about the 15-yard line.
That's a gain of 16. That makes it first and 10.
From the 15-yard line, it's first down.
Mike three. Run.
The 10. And he's tackled around the 7-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2.
Outside the goal line. That was a 6-yard completion, and we'll have first and 10 coming up.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play.
Touchdown, Tulane!
Be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Tulane gets set to kick this one away. He'll return it from the one. Gets to about the 24-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Makes the grab and steps out right away. He might have a chance. Nice run to the outside. Complete. He's got space to work, and he's taken down at the 49. They'll knock him down for a loss.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is firing up.
And a quick throw. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. The 22-yard line. First down. Short pass, middle of the field, and he is drilled at the 16.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision making.
Here's the 8th play of the series. The 10 makes it to the 8.
Easy.
the 10th play of this drive.
That brings up second and goal.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 6.
That's a gain of 2. That makes this third and goal.
And he tackles him hard at the 4-yard line. A couple of yards there.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
This one should be makeable. Texas is looking to go up by 3. It's up, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Tulane's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does. And now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion of the game a little bit. They're going to have to do it with somebody else, I think.
This is really where a coaching staff gets challenged, because for 5 or 6 days you prep and you look at a lot of film and you kind of come into a game by the time Saturday rolls around and you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense. And then you go out there and it's not working. You have to show an ability as a coaching staff to go back and look at that drawing board and eliminate some things and maybe add some things and be able to try to make the adjustments you need to give your team a chance to win in the second half.
Tackle made right around the 48-yard line.
Tulane's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
From their own 48-yard line, first down. He airs it out. And he's got it. He's taken down around the 10-yard line. Tacks on the extra point. This return should be the last play of the half. He'll need to break it all the way to give his team the lead. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Brought down in the open field. We've seen quite a bit of offense here as we reach halftime. Our score is 21-17, Tulane.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 23. Tulane's dreams are a reality in this football game. They've scored 21 points in a row. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Tulane is up by 4. Slings it. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Mike three.
And he's stopped behind the line.
I think a corner loves to have a chance to come up and make a play in the run game. So often they get labeled as just great athletes, and they just want to be involved in the passing game and being able to defend a receiver. Here, you see an attitude from this corner as he comes up, reads the play, and makes the play in the backfield.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. They give to the tailback. He makes it out to midfield. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Stop at about the 39-yard line. He's scrambling. He's at the 30. Tackle around the 27-yard line.
Great play by the defender to high point the ball, but the quarterback wasn't in rhythm on the throw.
From their own 20-yard line, it's first down. Tulane is up 4. In on the throw, he caught it. He's tackled at the 30. Strike to the receiver, and down he goes at about the 41. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 41. Fires it out, and he's tackled at the 48. Dumps it complete over the middle. Brought down at the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, first down.
Navajo!
this one away. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. And it's almost picked off.
That'll make it fourth and ten.
Tulane holds a 4-point lead. It has the distance, and he splits the uprights. Line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Quick pass, and he's taken down at the 40-yard line. For a nice run. They come out in a 5-wide set. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And he hits him hard at the 44.
This is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
The 10, the 5, touchdown, Texas!
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. To be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From their own 30-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line.
That brings us second and nine.
Two ties. Four down. Like three.
On the ground, left side. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That'll make it third and nine.
from their own 32-yard line. It's third down. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds around the 42-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, good game, 24-24. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. And he's leveled at the 35.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made around the 47-yard line. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Quick throw. Very good tackle in space. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down. That makes it first and goal.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Touchdowns on the ground today for this young man.
Until they can figure out how to slow him down, it's going to be very tough for them to get back into this game.
And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And they get nice yardage on that run. In the gun with five receivers. Pass right, running back's got it. He's taken down at the 48-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Heading for the corner. He's at the 30, knocked out of bounds at the 29-yard line. It's second and five here. Ball on the 24-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Steps out of bounds at the 23-yard line. The extra point to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Texas lines up for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Here's the halfback on the screen. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
From their own 27-yard line, it's first down. Right side, got his tailback, got some open field.
The back can consider himself very fortunate this time because the offense recovered. But the next time, he might not be so lucky.
They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Good open field tackle. First down grab by the receiver, and they make the stop at the 45. Goes to the receiver, incomplete. From the 45-yard line, it's second down. He's got it with room to run. Tackle at the 36.
Jack, 98 Weasel.
Under a minute left in the game. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. Complete. He's got room to work. He's pushed out of bounds around the 24-yard line. with room to work. We're going to overtime. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. And we're back ready now for overtime. Halfback's got it on a quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 19. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tackle at the 18, and he gets a yard on the run.
Just a great job here by the defender of timing the hit and getting him down.
See if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. First and 10. Ball on the 25. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And down he goes at the 20.
That's a deep five on the play. That brings him second and five.
Zips it to the tight end. Brought down at the 11. First and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. He's tackled right around the 2-yard line.
That brings up second and 1.
Brings it out left, and he stopped right away. Short yardage situation here. It's third and 1. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go. They come out on an empty backfield. Football 14 for Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports. Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.